So what I've done is that I have pressed under 3/8 of an inch along each of the long edges. And this is just the way I like to do a narrow hem without the narrow hem foot. I only press it under once, but then I just take my finger and tuck it under as I go. And if you look closely, you can see right here that I've established this point between the clear part of the foot and the metal part of the foot as the corner at which I'm guiding that first fold of the fabric. Okay, so you can finish this side. See how that works? It's a little bit easier if you press under more to begin with than what I've done. I'm going to go all the way to the end of the first side. Okay, then I'm going to turn this to the outside at a right angle. And I'm going to stitch from A to B. But I'm going to do that from this side so that I can see and stitch right along that point, or the line that I had pressed in for this side. Now, what I'll do is clip this corner and then turn it. I can poke that out. Although with my scissors is not the best tool to use. I like the bamboo point presser for that, but I forgot to pull it out. And then right here, I'm going to start and do the same thing that you saw me do when we first started. To make this video shorter, then, I'll show you how this nice tie end can look. A great way to finish off any kind of tails, like on a bonnet, on the back of a little girl's dress, or on an apron.